हेलो फ्रेंड्स, इन दिस लेक्चर वी विल कवर द नेक्स्ट टाइप ऑफ सेंसर दैट इज टेम्परेचर सेंसर्स। नाउ द लर्निंग आउटकम्स, नाउ आफ्टर स्टडिंग दिस टॉपिक स्टूडेंट विल बी एबल टू अंडरस्टैंड द फर्स्ट टाइप ऑफ टेम्परेचर सेंसर दैट इज रेजिस्टेंस टेम्परेचर डिटेक्टर और इट इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एज RTD। देन द सेकेंड टेम्परेचर सेंसर दैट इज थर्मोकपल एंड the third temperature sensor that is thermistor. Now before going to the temperature sensors that is RTD or thermocouple or thermistor, let's see what is the effect of heating and cooling. Now when the body is heated or cooled, then various effect of heating or cooling can be observed, and these effects includes first the change in the physical or chemical state, then the change in physical dimensions, then the change in electrical properties, and the change in the intensity of the total radiation emitted. So the existing temperature detectors use any one of the above four types means the change in physical or chemical state, or the change in physical dimensions, or the change in electrical properties, or the change in the intensity of the total radiation emitted. Now out of these four effects, we will concentrate on third effect, that is change in electrical properties, because for this lecture our objective is to convert our temperature into electrical equivalent, or our input measurement, that is temperature, into electrical equivalent. So when we will change our temperature, means when we will increase or decrease the temperature, then its electrical property should be changed, and that change we are going to observe in this lecture. Now let's start with the first temperature sensor, that is resistance temperature detector, or it is also called as RTD. Now it has been observed that the resistance of metal increases with increase in temperature. Therefore, the metals are said to have the positive temperature coefficient of resistivity. Means if suppose the temperature to the metal goes on increasing, then the resistance of that particular metal will increase, and this is nothing but what? The positive temperature coefficient of resistivity. However, the some semiconductor materials have negative temperature coefficient of resistivity. Now what is negative temperature coefficient of resistivity? Now for semiconductor materials, the negative temperature coefficient of resistivity means the temperature and the resistivity are inversely proportional. Means if suppose temperature will increase, then the resistivity will decrease. Similarly, if suppose temperature will decrease, then the resistivity will increase. So it is possible to convert the temperature variation into equivalent changes in the resistance, and this is the principle of the resistance type temperature sensor, and these transducer or these sensors are called as an resistance temperature detector, that is RTD, because if you see the resistance temperature detector means the resistance is totally depends on how much temperature is applied, either temperature increased or decreased, accordingly the resistance will goes on changing. Now let's see how to measure the RTD resistance. Now for measurement of RTD resistance, we are using one circuitry that includes the Wheatstone bridge. Then the output of your Wheatstone bridge is applied to the operational amplifier, that is op amp. Now here the RTD is the passive type of transducer, because it requires the external power supply for its operation. And here VAB or VBA is the output voltage, which is proportional to the temperature. Means when we will change the temperature, then accordingly the output voltage will change. Now let's see the working of the Wheatstone bridge. As we know, we always operate our Wheatstone bridge in two conditions, that is the balance condition, and second one is the unbalanced condition. Now what is balance condition? Now balance condition is nothing but what? if suppose R1 upon R2, that is the ratio, means R1 upon R2, which is equals to R3 upon the resistance of RTD, means these ratios are equal, then that indicates our bridge is in, or our Wheatstone bridge is in balance condition. And when our Wheatstone bridge is in balance condition, then the output voltage, that is VBA, will be equals to 0. Now, let's convert our balanced bridge into unbalanced condition. Now, how to convert it into unbalanced condition? Now, if you see, the RTD is connected in this bridge. Now, if you hit RTD by using your solder gun, then the temperature will increase. And as RTD has the positive temperature coefficient, that's why its temperature will increase. Its resistance will increase with increase in the temperature. Now, when you increase the temperature of your solder gun, then accordingly the resistance of RTD will increase. Now, when the resistance of RTD will increase, then your bridge will be in unbalanced condition. And when your bridge is in unbalanced condition, then your node voltage, that is VB, will be equals to R1 plus R2 into VS. VS is nothing but your supplied voltage. And if you observe the output of this bridge, that is VBA, now this voltage is having amplitude which is minimum. So you need to amplify this voltage. That's why the output of your Wheatstone bridge is applied to operational amplifier. Then your operational amplifier will amplify the signal and will give the appropriate output. This is how to measure the resistance of RTD by using the Wheatstone bridge. Now, which are the advantages and disadvantages of the Wheatstone bridge? Now, we can use, our RTD can be used for the measurement of small as well as the large temperature difference. Then they are highly accurate. Then high reproducibility, good dynamic response, that is, it responds very quickly to the changes in the temperature. And then the next advantageous thing, that is wide temperature range, that is in between -2000 degrees Celsius to 6500 degrees Celsius. So these are the different advantageous things of the RTD. Now, which are the different disadvantages? First, large size, then sophisticated instrumentation is necessary for the protection of resistance wire. Then it requires the external DC power supply for its operation. Then high cost. These are the various disadvantageous things of the RTD. Now let's see the next type of temperature sensor, that is thermocouple. Now what is thermocouple? A thermocouple is active temperature sensor. Now active temperature sensor, as we know, what is the difference between active sensor and passive sensor? Now the active sensors doesn't require any external power supply for its operation, but your passive sensors requires the external power supply for its operation. So a thermocouple is an active temperature sensor which produces an EMF which is proportional to the temperature difference between the two junctions, and it doesn't require any external DC source for its operation. And what is the principle of operation of thermocouple? Now the operation of thermocouple is based on the phenomenon called as Seebeck effect. What is Seebeck effect? Now Seebeck effect states that a current flows in a closed circuit made up of two dissimilar metals if the junctions of the metals are kept at the different temperatures. Means if the junctions are at different temperature, then current will start flow through the two dissimilar metals. Now this is the principle of the Seebeck effect, and due to this current flow, an EMF will produce which is proportional to the temperature difference which is produced. Now this is nothing but what the Seebeck effect. Now let's see the construction and the operation of the thermocouple. Now to understand the construction and the operation of the thermocouple, we will require two dissimilar metals. Now let's suppose X is the one metal and Y is the another metal. And now X and Y are two dissimilar metals which are joined together to form a junction J1 and junction J2. Now, if these junctions are kept at the different temperatures, that is, if suppose J1 is kept at temperature T1 and J2 is kept at temperature T2, then the EMF will produce, and this EMF will be proportional to the temperature difference, that is T1 minus T2. Now here this equation indicates that is E equals to K into T1 minus T2. Now E is nothing but the EMF produced, and K is nothing but the proportionality constant, because EMF produced is directly proportional, according to Seebeck effect, EMF produced is directly proportional to the temperature difference. That's why K is the proportionality constant, and T1 minus T2 is nothing but the junction 1 temperature minus junction 2 temperature. And in the temperature measurement system, using the thermocouples, one of the two junctions, that is either junction J1 or junction J2, can be maintained at a known temperature, and this known temperature is also called as a reference junction or the cold junction. And the reference temperature generally used is 273 degree Kelvin, or it 0 degree Celsius. Now if you see the second diagram, then you will observe a millivoltmeter, which is used to measure the thermally generated EMF. And the thermocouple elements are enclosed in a housing assembly for their protection, and the assembly is then called a thermocouple probe. Now this is nothing but the construction and operation of the thermocouple. Now which are the different materials are used for the construction of the thermocouple? Now there are total four combinations of the metal. First one is the copper constant ton, which have the temperature range is in between 0 to 2000 degree Farad. Then second combination is nothing but iron and constant ton, which have the temperature range is in between 0 to 1200 degree Farad. Then third combination, that is platinum and platinum rhodium alloy, which have temperature range is in between 0 to 3000 degree Farad, and the last combination, that is chromel and alumel alloy, which have the temperature range is in between 0 to 900 degree Farad. Now this graph shows the temperature characteristics of the thermocouple. Basically this graph is nothing but what the temperature, which is in degree Farad, versus the EMF produced, and that EMF is nothing but what the thermoelectric EMF. So it is a graph of temperature versus thermoelectric EMF, which is produced. Temperature which is in degree Farad is on x-axis, while the thermoelectric EMF, which is in millivolt, is on y-axis. And here there are total number of four combinations are given. First one is chromel constant ton, then second one is iron constant ton, then third one is copper constant ton, and the last one is the platinum and platinum or rhodium. Now which are the different advantages and limitations of the thermocouple? Now which are the different advantages? First, wide temperature range, means from minus 2000 degree Celsius to 11000 degree Celsius. Then external DC source is not required, as it is a active type of sensor. That's why it doesn't require any external power supply for its operation. Then the good sensitivity, that is for small changes the temperature can be sensed. Then the fast dynamic response, that is it responds quickly to any temperature changes, and it is less expensive and small in size. So these are the different advantages of thermocouples. Now which are the different limitations of the thermocouple? Now first limitation, the temperature characteristics of thermocouple is slightly non-linear. Then the thermally generated EMF is small, that's why the amplification is required. So to convert your temperature into electrical signal, you can convert it into by using your thermocouple. But if you are going to use same thermocouple for any application, then you will require the amplification. The output of your thermocouple will be given to your amplifier, then your amplifier will amplify the signal. Then the third limitation, that is cold junction compensation, needs to be done for accurate measurement of the temperature. So these are the three limitations of the thermocouple. Now what is thermistor? Now thermistors are also the temperature dependent resistors, that is RTD, and they are made up of semiconductor materials which have the negative temperature coefficient of resistivity. Now, what is negative temperature coefficient of resistivity? Now, in the thermistor, if temperature is goes on increasing, then its resistivity will decrease. Similarly, if suppose temperature is goes on decreasing, then its resistivity will increase. Means in case of your thermistor, your temperature and resistance are inversely proportional to each other. And the variation of the resistance which changes the temperature is non-linear. And thermistor can be used to measure the temperature in the range that is from minus 1000 degree Celsius to 3000 degree Celsius. Now let's see the temperature versus resistance characteristics. Now this graph shows on x-axis there is temperature which is in degree Celsius and on y-axis there is resistance. Now if you observe these characteristics are non-linear and if you observe these characteristics are negative temperature coefficient of resistivity, means if suppose temperature is goes on increasing, then resistance is goes on decreasing. That indicates the output of your thermistor have negative temperature coefficient of resistivity, means if suppose temperature will increase, then the resistance will decrease. Now the resistance of the thermistor can be expressed at by using the equation that is RT, which is equals to R naught or R zero exponential of beta in bracket 1 upon T minus 1 upon T0, where RT is the resistance at T degree Kelvin, R0 is the resistance at 0 degree Kelvin, then the beta is the characteristics temperature, and the thermistors are constructed by using the materials, by using the mixtures of materials such as sulfides, then selenide oxides of manganese, then nickel, cobalt, iron, or copper, etc. Now, which are the different advantages and disadvantages of the thermistor? Now, first of all, it is small in size and low cost. Then, comparatively large change in the resistance for a given change in temperature and fast response over a narrow temperature range. These are the advantageous things of the thermistors. And which are the different disadvantages? First of all, the temperature versus resistance characteristics is non-linear, then it needs the external DC power supply for its operation. Means that indicates our thermistor is the passive type of sensor and it is not suitable for wide range operation. Means because range is limited, which is from minus 1000 degree Celsius to 3000 degree Celsius. So these are the various disadvantageous things of the thermistors. Thank you.